Shortly after giving birth to her second child, Rose began to work as a prostitute, operating from an upstairs room at their residence and advertising her services in a local contact magazine. Fred encouraged Rose to seek clients in Gloucester's West Indian community through these advertisements. In addition to her prostitution, Rose engaged in casual sex with both male and female lodgers within their household, and individuals Fred encountered via his work. If the woman resisted or expressed any pain or fear, this would greatly excite Rose, who would typically ask, "Aren't you women enough to take it?" To many of these women, it became apparent Rose and her husband took a particular pleasure from seeking to take women beyond their sexual limits, typically via sessions involving bondage, as the Wests openly admitted to taking a particular pleasure from any form of sex involving a strong measure of dominance, pain and violence. The room Rose used for prostitution was known throughout the West household as Rose's room, and had several hidden peepholes allowing Freda, longtime voyeur, to watch her entertain her clients. Rose carried the sole key to this room around her neck, and Fred installed a separate doorbell to the household which Rose's clients were instructed to ring whenever they visited the household. Much of the money earned from Rose's prostitution was spent on home improvements. By 1977, Rose's father had come to tolerate his daughter's marriage, and to develop a grudging respect for Fred.